Evening, July 27. Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? Romans 8:33. Most blessed challenge. How unanswerable it is. Every sin of the elect was laid upon the great champion of our salvation, and by the atonement carried away. There is no sin in God's book against his people. He seeth no sin in Jacob, neither iniquity in Israel, they are justified in Christ forever. When the guilt of sin was taken away, the punishment of sin was removed. For the Christian there is no stroke from God's angry hand, nay, not so much as a single frown of punitive justice. The believer may be chastised by his Father, but God the judge has nothing to say to the Christian, except I have absolved thee, thou art acquitted. For the Christian there is no penal death in this world, much less any second death. He is completely freed from all the punishment as well as the guilt of sin, and the power of sin is removed too. It may stand in our way, and agitate us with perpetual warfare, but sin is a conquered foe to every soul in union with Jesus. There is no sin which a Christian cannot overcome if he will only rely upon his God to do it. They who wear the white robe in heaven overcame through the blood of the Lamb, and we may do the same. No lust is too mighty, no besetting sin too strongly entrenched, we can overcome through the power of Christ. Do believe it, Christian, that thy sin is a condemned thing. It may kick and struggle, but it is doomed to die. God has written condemnation across its brow. Christ has crucified it, nailing it to his cross. Go now and mortify it, and the Lord help you to live to his praise, for sin with all its guilt, shame, and fear, is gone. Here's pardon for transgressions past. It matters not how black they're cast. And, O my soul, with wonder view. For sins to come here's pardon too.